Okay, so we are going to create a AJAX program today one more time. Okay. I think today is day 8, so let's create a folder day 8. And what are the practice, good practices we have? 1.html, CSS and 1.js. Okay, so in the 1.html, what I will do, okay, so we have created a one simple HTML file. I am writing what? Hello world. Okay, can I run this program now? To run the program, where we'll go? To our go live button that is available on the bottom corner. So if I click this, we can see the output, hello world. Okay, what is our task? Our task in this program is that to make an AJAX call. So we have created JavaScript program 1.js. So what we can do? Can I link this here? And how to link a JavaScript file? Yes? Okay, we use what? Script tag. What is our file name? 1.js. Okay? What do we want? We want to call a AJAX. We want to make an AJAX call. So can I create a function here, make AJAX call? Okay, make AJAX call. And now what are the things that have been described over there? We will create an object of XHR. XHR means what? XML HTTP request object. What is our second task? Our second task is what? XHR.open. And this open parameter accepts how many parameters? 3 parameters. Okay, the required one is the URL. Okay, so what kind of request we are making? Okay, let's suppose method name is what? Type, request type. Can I create a separate like this? Get and const request URL. Now here we will define what? URL. What is the URL we are going to hit? Let's suppose we are going to hit the URL, this one. Or you can take any one example from here. List users. So what is the URL? requestResponse.in/API/users. So this is what kind of example? So this is a get. So if it is a get, we can always cross validate here. We can always open a get request in the browser. Why? Because browser understands get method. So let's come here now. So first parameter is what? Request type. Second parameter is what? Request URL. Third parameter is optional, but still we will pass true. Okay, this is an overloading. I hope you understand overloading. Now next is what? We need to attach, we need to bind the response handler. So what, how we are binding? On load. When we want our handler to be active, when the response will come, the response will be loaded. So this is an anonymous function. Okay, and right now I will just print. We will first print the value. How to print the value? Console.log. Who will help us to get the result? Who is the key? XHR. So we'll call here XHR.responseText. Because we are interested in JSON. And then finally, send the request to server. How to send? Okay, so now our method is ready. So now how to call this method? From HTML, can I call this method? Can you create a button here? Can I create a button? Okay, AJAX get call. So this is how our program looks. we have made a very bad UI. Okay, now can I call this method on? And again, one more thing, we'll check that whenever we are making our program, we'll check all our sources have been loaded or not. And what we can do, and there's another thing I always want you people to understand, that always try to put a debug point. Okay, and where we'll put our debug point, and line number 3 or line number 4? Not on line number 3, we'll put a debug point on line number 4. So if I click here, so it's not getting called, okay, because we have not called the method. So on click, what we want to do, we want to call the method, make Ajax. Is it correct? So we have to pass like this. Now if I call this, now you can see that whenever we are clicking, our method is getting called, any JavaScript method. But in this method, what we are doing, we are calling a Ajax request. Request type. What is the advantage of debugging? Sometimes what happens, we are able to understand what is the current state of a variable. Now here the request will be opened, and what we will do, we'll put a, this is an anonymous function, now tell me which line will be executed after 11, which line will be executed? After 11, line number 16. When this line number 12 will be executed? When the response will come from the server. So once the request will go after line number 16, you can see that the response has been come. From where? From the server. And we can see the response. Where? Using the response text. Is it clear? So you can practice one more time. Let's click. You can go step by step, but that is, this is the key here. On after line number 11, line number 12 is not getting executed. Why so? You have to understand after 11 where the request is going. 11 is containing what? It's containing an anonymous function, response handler. When that block will be executed? When the response will come from the server. Okay, sir, why we have written console.log? What is the output? So you can check the output here. If you write console.log, where it will appear? It will appear in your console tab. Okay, so in this way, what we have done, we have made a Ajax get request. Okay, now let's try to do what? Let's try to make a post request. Okay, let's try to make a post request. So let's take one good example of post create. To make a post example, what is the URL? URL name is what? API/users. Okay, so let's make a function, another function. Functions make Ajax call, make post Ajax call. Okay, again we'll repeat the same thing. What? XHR, either you can use let or const. XHR is equal to new XML HTTP request object. Then what? XHR dot open. This is your step number 2. What does it require? It requires 2 things. What are the things? Const dot type. What is the type? Type is post and URL. What is the URL? Again, let me copy this. The same URL is almost same. I think API/user itself. User is same. And before writing the program, what you can do, parallelly, what you can do, you can take the help of postman. Can I make a post call here? Post to check whether the whatever you are trying to achieve or simulate, it's correct or not. And since it is returning, it's what kind of request it is accepting? JSON. So I will make a copy of this. Where I will go? Not params. We'll go to the body tab. Inside the body tab, raw. Inside the raw, JSON. So now we'll try to send the request to the server. You can see that we have got a proper response. Okay, and if you make some mistake left, suppose instead of this you have written like this, we make some error in our URL, what will happen? Okay, it is accepting. Ideally this should not have happened. Or let's suppose I am making a change here in the URL. Okay, now it is saying that there is some error. Now the response is not JSON. Okay, so this URL is correct. So what we can use in our program? Okay, now here we'll do what? We'll make a request type and URL. And later on what we need to do? Onload, that means the handler. What here we will do right now, just print the value. XHR dot and finally what? XHR dot send. But sir, when we are sending a post request, how to, we need to send some data, yes or no? How to send the data? Okay, let me see. Ajax post JSON. I know at least one thing. Or no, let me try this first. What is that? We need to send some JSON data. Yes, data is equal to, let's suppose, what is the data we are passing here? What is the data we were passing? Name is equal to something. Name is equal to, let's suppose you are passing what? And data. Can I pass like this? Let's suppose if I'm passing like this, what will happen? Now what we have to do? We have to call the second method. Where? On our HTML. Now you can see that. Hello, can you see the response? That means the response has been, user has been created. Okay, that means what we have learned? The fundamental way how to make a get request and Ajax get request and Ajax post request from JavaScript using Ajax call. Okay.